Top stories worldwide this week at FCA. Third quarter results. Leadership changes. LGBT observance. All right now on FCA Replay. Sparked by continued global growth of the Jeep brand and strong North American sales, FCA reported a third quarter pre-tax profit of 1.3 billion euros. Adjusted for costs from recalls and a port explosion, FCA reported a 299 million euro loss for the quarter, compared with 188 million profit during the third quarter in 2014. Additionally, Jeep continued to grow globally with a 27% increase in shipments of vehicles, including the all-new Jeep Renegade.
We're encouraged by the results that we've obtained so far, especially in terms of EMEA and Latin American performance. We have been obviously highlighting the cost competitiveness of our Brazilian operations, and I think that even in market conditions which are less than exciting, we have been able to pull some profit, and I think it's the beginning of a recovery path.
Senior Vice President of Vehicle Safety and Regulatory Affairs, Scott Kunzelman, announced this week that he will be retiring in November from the company after 30 years with FCA. His downtime will be short, as he will become Chief Operating Officer at Oakland University in Michigan on December 1st. Visitors to the Chrysler World Headquarters and Technical Center in Auburn Hills, Michigan, this week saw the company's commitment to a diverse workplace on display as the company raised the rainbow flag at its main entrance and flew it in support of LGBT History Month. That's a look at this week's top stories from FCA. I'm Edward Cardenas, reporting for FCA Digital Media.